Hello there, hope I'm not waking anyone up. I'm Captain Peter McGilligully, and I'm welcoming you on this Air New Zealand flight to London via Bangkok. In case you haven't noticed, we've got one hum-ding-a-dong of a moon out there in the starboard window. Hope all that wolf howling back there is just my fan club.
You look just like Shell after she stood me up.
Yes. And remember, you've got a brother who loves you.
Now, Josie and John, you're obviously the next pair. We'd like a few more film and theatre styles.
Greek tragedy.
Yes, would you like that in the original Greek or in translation? So your situation that you have to improvise is breaking up with a partner.
It's all a case, really, Jane, of... I don't know.
Yes, John? What was it you wanted to say to me?
I was just going to say that... Well, it worked very well last Saturday, but now it's... I don't know. I want to go and do the dishes, OK?
Yeah, do the dishes, Daddy.
I'll see you later.
OK, let's do Shakespearean.
I feel that thou hast not giving thine heart.
Think not, madam, what thou comest with. Thou art all lean, thou art but a popinjay, far upon the hill, and I thy jesses.
Comest with nothing, whilst thou art concerned, sire.
But thou art juicy fruit in my bowl, good lady.
Blimey, Jack Nicholson's back.
Great to be back in Stella Street, huh?
You see that little bloke there? That's Al Pacino, that is.
This car makes my asshole fall out.
Your asshole fell out the day they premiered Bobby Deerfield, Al.
Jack, I got two words to say to you. Mars Attacks.
John, I dressed as the Beatles. I mean, for us, it was our ultimate.
It was very exciting to wear the Sergeant Pepper suits.
We're huge fab fans, aren't we?
Huge fab fans.
And there we were in the Pepper suits.
And I've just been talking to Alan Klein. The shop's doing dead good. We should be able to open six more.
Hey, Paulie.
What?
Where's Ringo?
He just popped out to get the new lottery tickets.
Hey, lads, I've got the new lottery tickets.
Hey, yeah, Ring, how you been, Ring?
Just got back from the Samosas. They were the last fresh items that Nick and Keith had. Doctors were taking the rest of the stuff away to make cultures.
You know, I hate to have a fucking hole cut in my fucking head like I'm a fucking mailbox.
Believe me, you're happy. You're delirious. Because tomorrow when you get my bill, you're gonna be fucking suicidal.
Oh. I think I'll stick to the National Health.
Human. To go from David Attenborough to Richard Attenborough, and when he was directing the great Ben Kingsley in Gandhi. You should probably know that. I think there were maybe 1 million, possibly even 2 million extras during Gandhi's funeral. And the first assistant, the very famous and doubtable David Tomlin, was told by Sir Dickie Attenborough to instruct the crowd as to how they may react. And he said to David Tomlin, I want you to convey to them, David, that Gandhi's died and it's an extraordinary event, darling. Extraordinary event in the whole history of India, darling. That Gandhi is gone, their god, their national hero is gone. So David Tomlin turned to the crowd and said, right, listen up. Gandhi's dead and you're all f***ing sane.
Excellent.
I paused many, many years ago, and during the silence, I heard a voice in the third row go, "Oh, you hideous beast, you've just come all over my umbrella."
If you were to ask me to name three geniuses, I'd go Milligan, Cleese, Everett, Sessions.
But you're jet-setting just now as well.
Oh, I'm an old pensioner.
Oh, are we?
I'm just coming into the tail end of my career now. I'm just hoping for that wee seat on Emmerdale, you know? No, I'm joking.
Hello there, Peter McGilligally again. Just thought you might like to know, we'll be scootering along to the land of the glittering pagodas at about 35,000 feet. And if you'll give me a few moments, I'll give that to you in inches.